Well, good afternoon, YouTube. My name is Viandom Tumkulu. Please like and subscribe if you want to hear more from my channel, you know what I'm saying? From me, this glorious night. Well, this weekend, I spent my time watching a lot of Netflix stuff, starting with Jessica Jones Season 2. Season 1 was so phenomenal, first of all. Like, it shattered everything, but it wasn't my favorite one because Dead Devil started it all, like Arrowverse. Arrow started it all, so I have a blind loyalty to the thing that started it all. But Jessica Jones was up there, you know? Like, it was better than season 2 of Dead Devil, to sum it up. You know what I'm saying? Season 2, I really enjoyed it. It went a direction I didn't think it would go, honestly. It was fantastic, because I wrote some notes, and the first note I wrote is that the season felt like it was still the same old Jessica Jones, just different, more interesting friends, if I'm gonna put it that way. I mean, like Trish, Malcolm, and Jerry became more interesting characters, more grounded characters. She was still the hard, boozy mess she always was, alienating people. Like, Jessica was being loyal to who she is. At the end, she changed for the better, but the consequences were already done, in my opinion. Another note, that's one of my high points of the season, that the girl we liked, Jessica Jones, was still herself. Trish, Malcolm, and Jerry became people more interesting to watch because their story went deeper. I would have liked Malcolm's story to go deeper because we only saw his college girlfriend. It's as deep as we got with Trish. We went flashbacks with Jerry. We went deep on the medical and saw her downfall, then saw her uprise again. Like, you know, Jerry's revenge was one of my highlights of the season, no lie. The theme song beginning part, I liked episode 1 now. They ended the episode with her eye facing the direction theme song goes up before it writes Jessica Jones. I was like, that was nice to see. I see what they did there. The new characters were interesting for the most part, except that PI dude. That PI dude that Malcolm ended up working with, he was just over the top for me. Like, he was just reacting over the top. Like, I didn't believe anything he was saying or trying to sell. And I'm surprised he was able to recruit Malcolm because it felt like dog shit for me. Anyway, I like the classic blue, how they were able to sneak in that Jessica Jones blue palette. It was just amazing. The storyline, the build-up was nicely, the pacing is better, the IGH, like the questioning throughout the whole season, whether they're the good guys, whether they're the bad guys, because they were saving lives, but they were destroying lives by saving lives. So it was kind of like, who did they really help in the situation? Which was an interesting take to the season. I really liked that. And the whole Jessica trying to uncover her past was so Luke Cage's. Like, it was so like Luke Cage season 1, but I let it slide because I really enjoyed it. It was a great direction to take the show. I mean, like, it was interesting enough, you know? It was a personal connection to Jessica because it wasn't just one awesome British dude called Kilgrave who just happened to stumble on a superpowered girl and fucked up her life. This was like deeply personal, like it was embedded. I saw the struggle. Like, I got iffy on like the last episode when they were doing that whole mother-daughter thing with Trisha and her mother and Jessica and her mother. Yo, but when Trish shot Jessica's mother, that was like, whoa. Did not expect that shit, I won't even lie. I was like, what? There were some nice Easter egg moments, like the Captain America action figure and the Lost Shield, then the Cloak and Dagger line, you know? There were some amazing moments that you were like, I see what you did there, ABC. Trying to make us think of the movies. And you even talked about the prison in the end of Civil War. I forgot what it's called, but it was just nice overall. I want to know, is Jessica Jones like a registered super since of the Sokova Accords? Is she registered? Because everybody seemed to know about her powers and nobody disturbed her whatsoever. Like, they didn't arrest her, because Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is a big deal if you're a powered human being. And there, it seems like you can live a normal life, just discriminating, in a sense. Trish's drug problem, that shit got deep, yo. Like, she took it on another level. She betrayed everybody. Like, everybody ended up being so selfish. Even Malcolm, to an extent, at the end. Jerry also, her illness made her more caring, more human. Then I was like, oh, there she is at the end. I was like, ah, nice try. Like I said, I really like them to go deep into Malcolm's past. Like, they keep talking about his parents, how he'll be mad, how his father's a writer, or quoting his father or something like that. And they never really tackle that. Maybe they will later on in third season of the show. It's definitely getting third season, I can tell. Oh, and Jessica and Trish burned so many bridges. That it was understandable that they only got their mothers at the end. Then Trish took the mother. But then she got another family, kinda. I think that's gonna go deeper. She's gonna be part of that family. She really wants that family dynamic. Weird enough, everybody kinda got what they wanted at the end. Just that they weren't friends anymore. It was the outcome, the consequence, if you may say. Like Jessica, Trish, Malcolm's life will never be the same anymore. Like, so many things happened this season that would shape their whole future. I wanna know if Jessica's gonna be different from now on. Is she still gonna be that whiny, booze drinking, lost person that she always is now that she kind of found a family, in a sense? I want her character to evolve. That was one of the downfalls of the season. I feel like she didn't evolve, like, until the end. But like, season one just gave her more PTSD. Defenders just made her more of a drinking, weird, superpowered, awesome girl. Like, it was just something else. Then Jessica's mother, the woman that played Jessica's mother, was amazing. Like, how she could switch from being caring for them, having this back and forth with Riberte and shit like that. It was interesting. Then out of nowhere, she'll just go psycho when it gets too personal. Like, give it up to Jessica's mother. That was amazing. Like, but what happened to Jerry when they played a trick on her, telling her they healed her and all that, and then they didn't? That was messed up. In all, I don't think it was better than season one. I feel like it was more personal and the characters were better. Like Trish, Malcolm, Jerry, everybody else, Jessica's mother, the new characters, they were better. Like, they found a way to tell the other characters besides Jessica's stories better in this season. But overall story, it wasn't scripting on some psychological thriller moment like Kilgrave was. I really appreciated the Kilgrave episode where he was in her mind, and that was a moment, like, just a moment for me. I was just losing it. Anything else? I really hope he comes back, because he says at the end, his last line was, "I'm here when you need me." And I was like, oh, we might get another Kilgrave in Jessica's mind episode. Because he was still his charming self. That's why I liked it. Like, I would like him to come back for good. Because I was so, oh man, I understand what it meant for Jessica season one to kill him. But I was like, nah, why you gonna kill him? Because it's like the cotton mouth situation all over again. Like, this season was so much kind of like Luke Cage in the grand scheme of things. I was experimented on truth about my loved ones, or I have a sibling I'm gonna have to face at the end type of shit. But it was an amazing story. It's like season one of Luke Cage told better, if you understand what I'm saying, because the switch up of villains to villains got it a little messy. Even this season was kind of like rocky, but it wasn't messy. It just went directions you didn't think it would go, which is good. The unpredictability of it all. It did get predictable in the season finale when it became the mother-daughter thing, but it's another situation. all in all, season one, I think I gave 9 out of 10 because last season was amazing. I think I'm going to give this one 8. It just wasn't satisfactory as the other one was, if you understand what I'm saying. Like, it wasn't the most amazing thing I've ever seen. Like, I expected, it's like Guardians of the Galaxy 2. It was satisfactory, it was enjoyable, but it didn't take it to unbelievable new heights. It made you want to stick and enjoy the ride more and more to see what happens next, you know what I'm saying? So I give it an 8 out of 10. Really enjoyed it. Thank you, like and subscribe. My name is Leandro Tumikulu. Hope you enjoyed joining me in this journey of mine. Oh, my English is bad today. Still got to do another review after this on top of that.